In Brooklyn, New York, at the turn of the century, lived two young Norwegians, so brave and so bold. Frank Samuelsen, only halfway through his 20s. George Harbo had just become 30 years old. Now Harbo had spent all his life on the water. He chipped in square riggers while barely a lad. His partner likewise was no stranger to working. No matter the task, he gave all that he had. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after adventure, and no one believed they could row all the way. Many men had attempted to cross the Atlantic in small wooden boats that were driven by sail. Those that succeeded were welcomed as heroes, but many there were who did nothing but fail. Then a rich publisher offered a challenge. The men in a vessel, no matter the size, could not make the crossing without steam or canvas, and $10,000 he named as the prize. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after adventure, and no one believed they could row all the way. Now dredging up oysters by hand is no picnic, and these two young fellas were tough as a whip. Said Frank, if we row only 4 miles an hour, for 54 days we could finish the trip. Obtaining a sponsor, they started their training. They ordered a dory made of cedar and oak, just 18 feet long, with a draft of 8 inches, and Fox was the name of their cockle-shell boat. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after adventure, and no one believed they could row all the way. On the 6th day of June 1896, Mr. Harbo and Samuelsen started to row. They took food and water to last until August, and the newspapers said they were foolish to go. On the slip in Manhattan, they rowed through the Narrows, then out for the Gulf Stream and on to the deep. Each day they would row 18 hours together. Each night they took turns getting 3 hours sleep. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after adventure, and no one believed they could row all the way. Well, their stove wouldn't light, so they ate cold provisions. Their arms and their hands became swollen and cramped. The odd passing vessel that took them on board was their only relief from the toil and the damp. And out on the Grand Banks, the weather attacked them. The wind humped the sea into mountainous waves. They lashed down their oars and they tied on their lifelines. Prayed they were not going straight to their graves. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after adventure, and no one believed they could row all the way. A monstrous wave hurtled out of the darkness, capsizing the Fox and her terrified crew. The lifelines held fast, but they lost half their water, and most of the food it was swept away too. They carefully rationed the little remaining bread. the brine. At last the tall ship appeared on the horizon, with the colors of Norway a-floating behind. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after adventure, and no one believed they could row all the way. The captain could not be convinced, they weren't crazy, but he gave them supplies, and they went on their way. By the lines on the charts, they were halfway to Europe, and now they must row 60 miles every day. The weather held fair, and the two men kept pulling, all during the days and far into each night, until early one morning, before the sun rose, far out on the horizon, they spotted a light. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after adventure, and no one believed they could row all the way. On August the 1st, they made a land at St. Mary's, on the south coast of England, close by Bishop's Rock. In amazement, the townsfolk gathered down by the water, where Harbo and Samuelsen barely could walk. Most men would have stopped then to bask in the glory, after having been sun-beaten, capsized and starved. But they were both back in their boat the next morning, and in less than a week they arrived in La Harbor. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after adventure, and no one believed they could row all the way. So all of you listening that yearn for adventure, like Harbo and Samuelsen so long ago, like them, be prepared for the task you'll be facing. They were not only brave, but by God they could row. We'll see you in France, or we'll see you in heaven, cried Harbo and Samuelsen out on the bay. Two hardy young oystermen after